What's in the box?
It's about to get crazy. It's about to go down. It's about to go down.
What can be in this box? It's only like 66 inches by 62 inches. You've seen some big boxes come over here housing some big equipment, right? What could be in this box right here? Before I show you, I just want to invite you to hit that subscribe button, hit the like button if you like this video, and put your comments down below. And if you have a certain technique or something that you want us to actually teach on, go ahead and put it in the comments section, and you might see it in a future vlog, all right? So what is in the box? Tormach right here, Titans of CNC. All right, so we got some Kennametal tools from the Building Blocks series, locked and loaded, ready to machine the Titan 1M. And we put the Synergy 735 in the coolant tank, the clear coolant from Blazer, and I got a big old heavy duty Shung Vice on this table. It's a little overkill, but it's gonna work, all right? So check this out. People might ask, like, Titan, why do you have a Tormach on your floor when you actually have a bunch of big old UMC 750SSs that get after it? You got the NLX 2500 from DMG Mori, you got the DMU 55 axis, 1600 inches a minute. Why do you need a Tormach? You wanna know why? Because Tormachs are awesome. They're awesome. As a machinist that's been around, I see just this maker movement, right? I see these engineers and kids going to college and stuff, and they're buying these machines and they're able to plug them into their outlets in the garage. And they're actually utilizing the academy to actually teach themselves how to machine. So I actually contacted Tormach and I was like, look, since you have so many students on the academy learning, how about I actually do some videos to actually teach them about the art of machining? Tormach has better machines, but I didn't want that machine. I wanted one of their smaller machines because I wanted to be realistic. Let's get a machine that's affordable, that like a father can buy for his 16-year-old kids. You know what I mean? Like, you just put it in the garage. It starts at about 7,000 bucks. This one is a little bit under 15,000 because it's got the servos and stuff like that, but it's less than a car payment. This machine is not the DMU, right? It doesn't have the 40 horsepower. It's not the Haas with a 30 horsepower. This machine has 1.5 horsepower and you have to treat it as such. So can you still make parts? Absolutely. I'm about to run the Titan 1M. But the approach changes, right? The cutters might get a little bit smaller. The radial engagement, you're still going deep, but it's lighter. You're taking that pressure off. You can still go, you know, 50, 100, 150 inches a minute, right? But I'm not even trying to tell you to be aggressive. Let's just bring it back. On here, I'm gonna rough it at about 80 inches a minute. And we're just gonna take a small radial, like 20, 25 thousandths. I know you can go 50 thousandths, I got it. You can even go more. But let's just go about 20, full depth radial. Let's just kiss it. Let's actually take advantage of some of the Kennametal tools that are so free cutting, right? So instead of just using a regular drill that drills down and pecks real slow, let's actually go to a Go drill and go 60 inches a minute easily on a Tormach with no horsepower. You know what I mean? There's an art to manufacturing. So that's the whole plan there, right? I just want to speak to the entire industry from the very bottom to the very top, right? So we got BB Aero, we got the aerospace parts, we're teaching how to machine titanium and Inconel and Monel, and we're bringing in big tools that need big horsepower, right? So we can actually make aerospace parts to print, ship them, and actually make money, right? So we're teaching you how to actually do that type of work. We're also just getting after it on the UMC 750s from Haas, just getting after it, teaching you five-axis machining and the rotation and the full simultaneous boom, 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 right? And those machines are crazy affordable, but not for a 20-year-old, right? Not for a 60-year-old guy who basically works a job, takes care of a family, and basically wants to have a hobby on the side, right? This is affordable. Never in the history of the world could you like literally buy a legit CNC machine for $7,000 and up, right? And then have an academy that teaches you how to design the parts, how to program the parts, how to machine the parts, and all of it comes to you for free. People keep saying like, oh, you can't make it free, you can't do this. Absolutely, because I got some great partners and they have stepped up to allow us to actually bring the academy to everyone for free. And one thing that I'll say also is that, you know, it's great to have Jason and Chris here from Tormach. These guys came in and actually helped me get the machine set up and stuff. But it was great just talking to them, because my biggest thing is like, you know, I'm not trying to compete with other people, right? And they're like, look, our vision is not to ever to compete with these other companies. Our vision is to get a machine into somebody's hands that would never have an opportunity to have a machine like that. And then if they graduate to a Haas, to a Mori, then we've been successful, because we've allowed people to come into the industry that never could have had an opportunity. And I love that. This industry is huge. Everybody's talking about the skills gap. Everybody's talking about this. And I've always said, there is a training gap. There is an awareness gap. There's a million people working at Home Depot, McDonald's, and all these service industries. And they don't even have a clue that manufacturing exists. It's companies like Tormach and Haas Automation that help bridge the skills gap, right? So you start pouring into your kids, you teach them the CAD, the design, they can actually make anything, and all of a sudden the schools step up, you start having Tormachs, you have Haases, you have different machines, and then it's just levels of rising up. Why should a school actually just look and say, okay, we can afford three of these machines? Well, maybe you get, you know, four Tormachs, then you have a couple mini mills, and then you have a VF2SS with some speed to it. And then later on, get a UMC 750 or something, right? Which allows you to rise through the ranks. All right, so let's go check out this part that we just made, all right? Oh, and there you have it. Check it out, check it out. Oh, the Titan 1M. Oh, it looks pretty, looks pretty. You know, one thing that I'll say is that, you know, on this part, I didn't have a face mill that actually fit this machine, so I just gotta go get a little 2-inch face mill that we can actually run with the right tooling for the machine, and we're gonna be good. But we wanted to get after it today because the machine's on the floor, let's make some chips, right? So we just took the 3/8 end mill, went around, boom, 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 came across the top. Part looks absolutely beautiful. I haven't made any adjustments. Pretty much 1.9 on the money, right? Going in X right here, we're about 4.0035, so you know, about 3.5 thousandths oversized on the 4 inches, but we have cutter comp, right? So if on one side I'm at 1.9 and on another side I'm at 4.0035, then I can just decide to put some comp on there and actually split the difference or make an adjustment to my program if I wanted it to be perfect. But the point is, Tormachs aren't made to be perfect. Tormachs are made to actually make parts, right? So plus or minus 5 all day long. A lot of guys do plus or minus 1 and they make crazy parts, right? But there's an art to it. There's a system to it. So I'm not going to speak to that. But knowing that this is my very first part and we're within 3.5 thousandths and there's no comp in place, that's good news. So we tapped it. So let's check out the thread. 1032, go, no go. So I'll just pop this in. Boom, 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 boom. No problems. And I come in here. And it stops right there. No go does not go. The go goes, which tells us that we have a good thread right out of the gate. All right, 1032, the dimensions, we're gonna do some more checks, but right now I'm happy with what I got. Again, I'm not trying to get tense on the Tormach. I'm not trying to get tense, but it's a cool machine. I want it in my garage at home. Boom, the Titan 1M, we are out. All right, Tormax in the house. Boom.